Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, we also have a daily answer writing series in which what we do, we daily give you a certain number of questions of which you have to write the answers. So regarding the question series, daily answer writing series, the students were demanding that please sir also upload the model answers of those questions which you give. So based upon that demand, we decided to daily discuss one model answer so that you people can get an idea about how to approach answer writing and how to deal with a particular question with relation to its directives that are given and what with relation to the demand of the question. So today's question is, can death penalty in POCSO Act prevent sexual harassment of children? Justify with suitable examples. So friends, here the death penalty that is there prescribed in POCSO Act, so we have to analyze the effectiveness of it in preventing the sexual harassment of children, and you have to justify it with suitable examples. So when you are asked to justify, you will have to look at both the aspects, that is in the favor of and in the negative sides, and also then you have to justify each side with suitable example. Say for example, if you are saying that it is not suitable, then justify with examples, and when you are saying that yes it is suitable, then also justify with suitable examples. So friends, before starting, let me tell you that we have the habit that we don't call our answer as model answer, because no answer in UPSC can be model answer, because every question has its answer has its positives and negatives. Had that been the case, that is of model answer, the UPSC toppers would have scored 100% marks. But you can see the topper, the marks of the toppers range between 50 to 55%. So keeping that thing in view, we call our answer as reference source. So it is better if you use the word reference source. So let's start our answer. So friends, recently the amendments have been passed to this POCSO Act 2012 to provide option of stringent punishment including death penalty for committing sexual assault and aggravated penetrative sexual assault crime on a child. So what are the key changes? Key changes are basically what you must understand the different terms that are used in POCSO Act, that is penetrative sexual assault. So the bill increases minimum punishment for this offense from 7 years to 10 years. So in that case, earlier the minimum punishment was of 7 years, but now this punishment has been increased to 10 years, and it also provides with imprisonment between 20 years to life with fine if person commits penetrative sexual assault on child below the age of 16 years. That means above the 16 years, the punishment is minimum 10 years. If the accused is found guilty, then he or she is bound to get 10 year imprisonment. But if in case the child is below 16 years of age, then the minimum punishment will range from 20 years to life imprisonment. So then there is also aggravated penetrative sexual assault, which is defined in this act. So this bill adds two more grounds to definition of aggravated penetrative sexual assault. So what does aggravated penetrative sexual assault would mean? So aggravated penetrative sexual assault will mean will be construed as assault which results in the death of the child, and assault that is committed during natural calamity or any similar situation of violence. So it increases the minimum punishment in this case from 10 years to 20 years and maximum punishment to death penalty. So please note the difference. You might be saying that now, earlier the minimum punishment was 10 years already mentioned in the answer. Now I'm saying that minimum punishment is 20 years. So you must know that this is basically the difference due to penetrative sexual assault and aggravated penetrative sexual assault. So penetrative sexual assault is punishable with minimum 10 years of imprisonment, and aggravated penetrative sexual assault is punishable with minimum 20 years of Life imprisonment and increasing it to death penalty as well. So as I've already told you that this the definition has been amended, and then there is also focus upon child pornography, so that no form of kind of, we can say, data relating to child pornography is shared over different platforms, and nor it is stored. So there is a provision for punishment for child pornography. It defines that any visual depiction of sexually explicit conduct that involves child, such as photograph, video, digital, or even computer generated image, indistinguishable from actual child. So it also enhances the punishment for certain offenses related to child pornography. And then storage of pornographic material is that if it is stored, then punishment is there for storage of pornographic material with imprisonment between 3 to 5 years or fine or both. So also then there are two other offenses for storage of pornographic material involving children, that is transmitting, displaying, distributing such material except for the purpose of reporting it, and failing to destroy or delete or report pornographic material involving child. So role of police has also been changed. The act cast the police in the role of child protectors during the investigative process. So this is basically to ensure that the victim is not re-victimized. So the police personnel receiving a report of sexual abuse of a child are given the responsibility of making urgent arrangements for the care and protection of the child, such as obtaining emergency medical treatment for the child and placing the child in a shelter home, and bringing the matter in front of child welfare committee should the need arise. And then there are also safeguards that that provisions for avoiding the re-victimization of the child at the hands of judicial system. So there is a provision for special courts which can conduct in-camera trials without revealing the identity of the children, and in a manner that is most child-friendly to the victim. So hence the child may have a parent or other trusted person present at the time of testifying and can call for assistance from an interpreter, special educator, or other professional while giving evidence. Above all, the Act stipulates that a case of child sexual abuse must be disposed of within 1 year from the date the offense is reported. So there has been a stipulation that this child sexual abuse is stipulated as is disposed of within 1 year, so that there is kind of certainty of conviction, and there must be a certainty of we can say the trial, because otherwise the main problem with Indian judicial criminal justice system is that it takes too long to dispose of a case. And then there is also mandatory reporting that says that mandatory reporting must be there of sexual offenses. So this casts a legal duty upon a person who has knowledge that a child has been sexually abused to report the offense. So if he fails to do so, he may be punished with 6 months of imprisonment. So now comes the part of justification of death penalty. So what is the case of justification of death penalty? So justification of death penalty is, it refers to the judgments of the Supreme Court in Machi Singh 1983 and the Devenderpal Singh, in which the court had held that the death penalty can be awarded only in the rarest of rare cases. So this is the justification, because it is in favor, the arguments are given that it is applied in rarest of rare cases, and there is a case, there is a test kind of, we can say the test is applied of rarest of rare cases. So in fact, in Machi Singh and the Devenderpal Singh cases, the court held that if it is awarded in rarest of rare cases, then why it should be done away with. And then also bill provides for added legal protection to 39% of the population or 43 crore children, irrespective of whether they are a girl or boy. So the amendment is expected to discourage the trend of child sexual abuse by acting as a deterrent. So because if there is death penalty, then the people will be deterred to do such acts, and if there is kind of, we can say, stringent punishments, then the person will be discouraged to do such activities. So it intends to protect the interest of vulnerable children in times of distress and ensures their safety and dignity. So also it is aimed to establish clarity regarding aspects of child abuse and punishment thereof. So now next comes your why it is not justified. So this is those who are saying that it is not justified, they are saying that often this abuse is done by the family members. So often it is found that the child has been abused by the family member itself. So if there is a provision of death penalties, so this may discourage the registration of the crime itself. So there may not be any registration of the crime. So this will be a kind of grave violation of child rights. And then it may also threaten the life of the minor, because as it is saying that if it resulted in the death of the children, then there will be death sentence. So it may lead to kind of further, because for the death for the murder is also the maximum sentence is the death sentence. So it may threaten the life of the minor. And also in J.S. Verma committee, which was set up in 2013 in the aftermath of a Nirbhaya case, after due deliberations, it reached to the consensus that death penalty should not be imposed in rape cases. And in fact, 262nd Law Commission report of that is submitted in 2015 also provides for the abolition of death penalty except in terror cases. So the question is, it largely diverts the attention from the core issues of infrastructural apathy, procedural lapses, and trial delays. So often death penalty is kind of seen as panacea for all ills, but the other problems that are infrastructural apathy, and then there are procedural lapses that are there, and then the possible trial delays. So all these things could divert the attention from core issues. And the provision conveniently weighed the fact that it is the certainty of punishment rather than its severity which has deterrence in real sense. So here it is found that in India the conviction rate is very low, because NCRB data found that only 3% of such cases have been reached to the level of a conviction. The prosecution has achieved the conviction only in 3% of such cases reported as child sexual abuse. So if such low is the conviction rate, then obviously it doesn't create that trend, because when there is certainty of punishment and when there is a speedy kind of trial, then the people are more discouraged to involve in such activities, because there must be a kind of deterrent in the sense that that punishment will be given. So research at the global level has also shown that despite stringent punishments, there are no fall in rate of crimes. And also NCRB data as said that the conviction rate in POCSO cases is 29.6%, while pendency is as high as 89%. I misinterpreted. Actually, it was basically child rape cases in which their conviction rate is 3%. But in case of all types of sexual abuses, the conviction rate is 29.6%, while the pendency is 89%. So you can see that the long trial it takes, it leads in re-victimization of the child, and then delay in the justice, and then it also removes the threat of the law from the mind of the accused, and then or the potential accused ones, and then there is also issue of we can say the child right abuse. So prescribed time limit of 2 months for trial in such cases is hardly complied with, and NCRB data of 2016 has shown that 3% of the rape cases that came up before the courts ended in convictions. So way forward is basically there must be a time bound trial. So as is said, the 2 months trial will be there, then it must be ensured that this kind of we can say the timeline is adhered to, and then national database for such cases has also been started, and 6.2 lakh sexual offences cases were registered in that case. And sharing the details of awareness program among children must also be the way forward, so that children can know about the good touch and bad touch. And in fact, CBSE is carrying out various programs in schools across the country relating to it. So problems related to implementation, such as lack of adequate special courts, lack of sensitization for investigators and prosecutors in dealing with child victims, poor rate of convictions, need to be resolved urgently. So the 29.6% conviction rate is in itself very low, so it must be increased. And then also in cases of rape cases, it is as low as 3%, so it must also be increased. And also there must not be delay, so special courts must be set up 60 days of the within 60 days. Supreme Court gave the direction of setting up of special courts within 60 days of the order in each district having more more than 100 pending cases under the Act must be complied with urgently. So there must be special courts with special infrastructure, with special care for children, and sensitization on the part of investigators and prosecutors for the child rights. And there must also be kind of certainty of conviction. So severity in itself doesn't result in much, we can say, desirable outcomes. So provision of death penalty should be discussed widely, and it must be applied only for the rarest of rare cases. And awareness and sensitization of people is equally important to prevent the crime itself. And there needs to be an urgent overhaul of the entire criminal justice system in the country, rather than emphasizing on the death penalty. So also then there is National Child National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, which is toothless. So government must provide for an independent National Children Tribunal, so that there is a kind of deterrent as well as a mechanism which can ensure the child rights. So friends, this is all about today's question. So if you like this question, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if in case you are interested in our answer writing initiative, then you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can contact us at 89689-20720. So daily we give you 3 questions, and we evaluate your answers within 48 hours, and also we provide you with model answers. So in this case you are getting the model answer of only one question, but in case you join our initiative, then you will be given the model answers of all the questions, better say reference sources, and also your answers will be evaluated. So certainly there will be a minimum cost for it, which has been kept for the purpose of your affordability and for the purpose of our motivation. So if in case you are interested, do ensure that you contact us, and links will also be there in the description box for joining our test series. And also you can visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, or our Telegram channel, you can join it, so on which we daily update various initiatives that are taken by us. So this is all about friends today's video. Do ensure that you like it and share it with your friends. So thank you, have a very nice day ahead.